I'm Brett McCaffrey with the Burning Group. I'm here with Andrew Martell, business analyst with the Burning Group as well. You've been with us now for
a little over a year now.
Just a little bit over a year. Yep. So this is going to be our very first video spotlight profiling Andrew. Getting to know a little bit about you and what makes you tick. So as the incumbent, the last person to go through the spotlight, I will be asking you the questions.
All right.
And getting some insight into Andrew Martell. So let's start off. The very first question, what three traits define you?
Aside from me being very funny, as my mother tells me, I would have to say that I'm really energetic. I like to keep busy, do stuff, outgoing, like to meet new people, and overall just like to have fun. Like to, you know, keep busy and you know, do stuff.
Yeah, work hard, play hard.
Exactly.
So what would you say is your personal philosophy?
Personal philosophy, it's always changing. You know, in grade 10 is probably an Aerosmith lyric that I no longer remember, but right now it's really just working with people that we share similar interests and similar goals. And that's even, you know, in a personal standpoint, just have friends who have similar goals, similar interests. And for me, it adds that extra level of enjoyment. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like if we succeed, if we were able to do stuff that we both enjoy, you know, we kind of have that extra success.
Great. Yeah. What's one thing that you couldn't live without?
Oh, other than long walks on the beach, I don't know, Brett. No, I have to say different art. So obviously not paintings and stuff, but I mean, you know, music, movies, books, stuff like that for me has always been interesting. It's always been, you know, a sense of with the imagination and kind of escape.
Right.
So I've always enjoyed that. So living without that would be really difficult and probably boring.
Yeah, absolutely. So what would you say true leadership means to you?
Aside from this current presidential election in the US, I frankly don't know. But no, I'd have to say that for true leadership, it's someone who's personable, they're approachable, it's someone that you're not intimidated by, but you respect. So anytime that I have to lead, I obviously try to be approachable. And if I work with leaders, you kind of want a leader who's approachable, who's personable, you feel comfortable going to for feedback or constructive criticism if that's the case.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
So finally, how would you define success? What does that mean to you?
Defining success, that's tricky. I know for you it was just the dictionary of what is success. Yeah, exactly. For me, it's always kind of what's that next step. So you have a success, you have a goal, you achieve it, but then it's never stopping. It's what's the next goal, but it's always being happy with what you're doing and where you want to go. So for me, you know, it's what's point A that I need to achieve and succeed at, who can I succeed with, and then once you get to A, it's then finding B. So it's that continuous pursuit of success, I guess.
All right, excellent.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much.